We're talking local and slacker this morning because all 18 of the SABC's radio stations will play 90% local music from today. The decision was made after consultations with stakeholders in the music industry. Well, in studio now, we're joined by the SABC spokesperson, Kaizer Kganyago, as well as one of the well-known musicians in the music industry here at home, Don Laka. Gentlemen, good morning to you and welcome to Morning Live.
Good morning, Professor.
Thank you very much indeed for your time. Now, Dr. Kganyago, I believe the SABC is very serious with local content. We do know that the COO was talking local content last week. He met with some of the independent producers. Now this.
Oh, definitely. People will remember that 3 weeks ago, we issued a statement where we were saying we are bringing 4 new channels that will deal with languages, because we believe that local content has to start with languages. Then last week we called the production industry, where we basically said to them that we want to have them produce local content all over the provinces and everywhere else. And this week we came with the quota for local music content. And for us, we are saying that the heritage of this country has to be appreciated and make sure that our cultural issues are put to the fore. And that is why we are saying local is lekker, and we'll continue. As the COO has said, we'll make sure that the people appreciate what is our own.
Just before we continue with the interview, let us just take a look at this insert.
A consultative meeting with stakeholders in the industry, the aim to find a way to improve and support local content.
We depend on you. And the day I'm going to enjoy my life is when I see all African languages are catered for in all these platforms.
A move supported by many in the industry. Today, another milestone. The South African Broadcasting Corporation, SABC, will implement 90% of local music across the 18 radio stations.
We have been meeting all stakeholders. We are not just focusing on the artist. We are focusing on local content. And we are appealing to all independent producers, emerging producers, to cooperate with SABC and assist the SABC to refresh its content. We are saying this is South Africa. We are prepared to work with you. So it is an exciting time for the SABC. All our radio stations, 18 radio stations, will be playing local content. Our television platform, they will also reflect local content.
The music to be played will be across all genres. In addition, the SABC will play more music from legends in the industry as well as up-and-coming artists.
Well, there you have it, the CEO emphasizing that SABC prioritizes local content. We're still talking to the SABC spokesperson, Kaizer Kganyago, as well as one of the music industry's veterans, that they don't like. And that they like. How do you feel about this decision by the SABC? It might be quite a dream come true for many musicians, if not all.
This is a landmark decision, and I was telling Brakeza yesterday that I haven't had a sleep. They nearly gave me a heart attack yesterday when the news broke. Well, we were in a meeting, and in that meeting, I had prepared myself to come and fight. And I think they said, we're going to show him this one, mm-hmm. that his time of fighting is over now. And without actually letting me say anything, the COO just announced, and what shocked me even more was when he said, tomorrow. And tears started running down my eyes, and I started, you know, and because I've never anticipated such a move that culturally will be liberated within less than 12 hours. So I'm saying today we mark and celebrate the death of cultural imperialism, and we'll see South Africa changing from what it was before into creating all those stars we've been wanting, or people mimicking overseas, and this landscape is changed forever, and it needed a leadership like we have. If we didn't have this type of leadership that SABC has now, we'll be still carrying banners, making noise out there. And Brakeza shot me when I started making noise. He said, we will listen. And they did listen.
Well, they definitely did. Now, but what implications will this have on local artists?
You know, people don't understand that the implications are so far-reaching. Job creation, I assure you, within 2 months, you'll see the industry will have transformed, changed, a lot of jobs created. Young filmmakers who will be shooting videos for the content that is going on radio starting today. Everyone will be wanting videos. Myself, I want to have my videos this weekend already started, so we'll be starting to shoot videos. I mean, it has never happened. I've never had a video in 10 years. So, you know, you can imagine so many young film producers now will be actually coming to the fore, and the festivals will actually go back to where it was before, and the whole industry will benefit from this. The economy of this country will just boom.
I can imagine. Dr. Kganyago, I think the most important issue here is that of royalties. How is it going to be handled?
Now, obviously, there are collecting agencies out there that will continue to do that. But all that we are saying is because there's going to be a lot of airplay on our platform, it means there will be more money generated to our local agencies that are collecting. And obviously, we will also monitor that because the COO has said from now onwards, the implementation of this will be monitored from his office to make sure that it is up and running. We'll also monitor these collecting agencies to make sure that the money that is intended for the artist ends up in the hands of the artists, because we are tired of a situation where people die poor because and they have been entertaining us all their lives, and we will make sure we monitor that very, very closely.
I actually wanted to come to the issue of monitoring as to how it's going to work, because I remember back in 2010 during the World Cup here in South Africa, a decision was made that more local music should be played, and it really didn't look like it got to a point where it was satisfying. So you're saying that monitoring will be coming from the COO's office in this regard?
He said to me yesterday that from now, the people in the content division who are responsible for content and the music people will then report and give reports every week to his office to make sure that this thing is still on plan or on track. Because if we don't do that, we'll not be able to monitor this whole thing. We have got the 90% that we are having for local content, local music, and the 10% for other music that is from elsewhere in the country, and we'll make sure that it's implemented. But I can safely tell you, I've been listening to our radio stations coming here. They are playing local music. Okay. And one people sometimes ask the question, yeah, but how are you going to sustain this in commercial radio stations and so on? And we are saying, we are not changing the format of the station. We are just saying, if it is an R&B song, it must be local R&B. If it is a hip-hop song, let it be a local hip-hop song. The formats of the stations will remain the same. And the other important thing that we need to mention is the issue of us saying, we don't want Lesedi to only play Sesotho music. We want in cross-cultural music played so that people understand the cultures of other people, because that is what we were intending to do.
Now, Dr. Laka, looking at the visuals, the COO had a standing ovation from stakeholders. How would you describe our COO here, and how do you feel about this commitment to not only play local music, but to consciously see to it that different genres gets the same attention?
Well, I've already posted on my Facebook page that this man has changed my life and the lives of South Africa for good, by the way. And you know what, I will defend this decision. I was telling Brakeza now that I will defend, and the people that follows me, the South Africans, the music industry, will defend this decision to sit stick and to make it a reality that has started today. So by all means, we will actually going hitting the ground starting today. We'll travel the length and breadth of this country, celebrating this, celebrating the SABC, celebrating the new landmark decision made by the SABC. And those who swim against the tide, unfortunately, they'll be caught up. So the better they make, the sooner they make the decision, the better, because you cannot go against this 18 radio stations that has reflected the people of South Africa and the culture of South Africa and the languages and what we have been fighting for all these years. Now it has come back home. And this is, for me, marks now the whole realization of the freedom of this country.
Now, Dr. Kganyago, obviously we have variety of audiences within the SABC. Is the decision not going to, in a way, shut out those that believe in international music? Are you not shutting them out from, you know, the whole world?
No, we are not. And for people who travel, you will know that when you go to other countries, you arrive there and they play their own music. And we are doing the same here. And we would have loved to have 100%, but we have said, because there are people who want to listen to other, what so-called international music, because international music is relative. Our music in their countries is international too. Therefore, we are accommodating them with the 10% that we are having. We are saying 10% of the music will be from elsewhere, 90% from here. And we are saying, for the people of South Africa, you need to listen to the music, hear the music, for you to know that you love the music.
But then you are to engage with the public. Why only now? I mean, the decision has already been taken. Why only now?
No, we have made a decision to say, let us put this thing out there, and then the public will react to it. And when the public reacts, we will review it, depending on what is happening. Because, unfortunately, it's not something that we can sit and say, do you love this? And they say, what is it that we have to love? Because we don't hear it. We say, hear it first, feel it first, and then after you've felt it, tell us how you feel about it.
Okay. Unfortunately, that's where we're going to leave it. Hope we had more time on this issue, but thank you very much for clarifying it for us.
Thank you.
Thank you very much indeed. There you have it, SABC spokesperson Kaizer Kganyago, as well as one of the veterans in the music industry, that they don't like. A Money Life takes a break. We continue after this. Stay tuned. Zakia, 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 Zakia